results are in the next half hour. Andrew Lloyd Webber will be making his last save of the series. But which Nancys have sung their way into next week's live final? Rachel, Jesse, Samantha, or Jody? Here, and all hungry for success, it is our Nancy and Oliver Army! Dressed in the same old rags, poor little things. But at least Gwion, Lawrence and Harry will be living it up in fine Dickensian style now that they have officially become our three winning Olivers. Don't miss their exclusive performance of Where Is Love later. So, out of our four girls that remain, two will be in the sing-off. There could be a major upset tonight. And it will be Andrew's last and most important save of the series. After that, you take control when you and your votes decide who wins that dream role in our live grand final next Saturday. Back again to share their views is the panel. John Barrowman, Denise Lenhouten, Barry Humphreys, producer of Oliver Sir Cameron McIntosh, and the legendary phantom running on his last reserves of power, Andrew Lloyd Webber. The Lord's power is fading. Next week, you are going to be in the driving seat. In a moment, our Nancys will be stepping back in time for their next mission. But first, here's a roundup of what's been happening in Nancy and Oliver Land.
That was phenomenal. You were absolutely fantastic. I'm shaking with excitement.
That was Rachel, Rachel, Rachel!
You took a wonderfully well-known song and you infused it with your own personality.
Bravo, you. It's so great to see you come through like this. Fantastic.
I am shaking, I am shaking.
I thought it was a good vocal, Jesse, but we're in the ninth week of the competition, and I have to be honest with you, it should excite me. It didn't. It slightly bored me.
I do very strongly disagree. You have a great emotional directness, Jesse, which is so appealing, so really beautiful.
Do you know what? I feel great, because if I go out tonight having done a performance like that, having done it from my heart, I will be so happy with myself.
First time I did see vulnerability in the first part of the song, but as you went for the money notes, I lost that a bit.
You have something so wonderful about your personality, and that's exactly what we need from Nancy. She has to be liked by men and women.
That performance showed that you're a powerhouse performer.
When I'm down and I'm feeling blue.
Do you know what? I feel like I want to run up and give you a big hug. That was so heartfelt. You are what this competition is about, Jodie.
Early on, you were accused of overacting, and now I think you might be a little too restrained.
I thought it was a beautiful, beautiful performance, but slightly matronly for me, and that could be the same thing that Barry's talking about.
What you did was exactly what I thought you should do tonight. I thought you were really on the bump.
Tomorrow, I love you, tomorrow.
The three Olivers are Gwion, Lawrence and Harry! Thank you. ladies are here with me now. That was an amazing semi-final. The votes could go any way at all. I mean, an impossible question, really, but how much do you want to make it to that final?
I tell you what, Graeme, I know I'm speaking on behalf of all those girls, but it would mean the absolute earth to each and every one of us. It really was. I mean, I'm going to give up singing before. I can't believe I'm hearing it. It's just one step away from fulfilling your dream.
I know. One of us has to go. Yeah. You know, we've all showed that we've got Nancy traits. We all could play the part, but just it has to happen.
You've all done an amazing job, and it is miserable we're going to lose one of you, but good luck to all four of you.
Thank you.
In the musical, Nancy leads a hard life, living in a Spartan, dirty hovel. So this week, we sent them to a Spartan, dirty hovel to get to grips with Nancy's hardship. It was definitely character-building stuff.
This week, our semi-finalists leave the glamour and comfort of the Nancy Mansion to step back in time. They are going to experience firsthand what life was like for Nancy by spending the night in an authentic Victorian home with not a mobile phone or TV in sight.
You walk into this place and it really hits you. It's really quite somber.
Everything's made out of wood. There's no heating. Look at her toothbrushes.
Ooh. I mean, my mum's got old-fashioned taste, but not as bad as this.
This room looks like my garden shed.
Making dinner, you know, without a ready meal or a microwave. It's been a real experience.
Cheers, girls.
This is being final four.
This mission is bringing us closer to the heart of Nancy.
The next morning is a test to see who has got into character, as now they must speak, not sing, Nancy's tragic love song, As Long As He Needs Me, in front of legendary Fagin, Barry Humphreys.
Four girls left. Each of them is capable of giving a supreme performance. Today, I'm expecting a very high standard indeed.
I'm starting to really be not Jessie anymore, but actually be Nancy.
As long as he needs me. Oh, yes, he does need me.
Jessie's performance to me was very convincing. It was heartfelt. And the motivation, to me, was very true.
To speak a song with no piano, they are literally stripped bare.
I miss him so much when he's gone. The way I feel inside.
I saw something in Rachel that I'd never recognised until then.
He doesn't say the things he should.
There is a commanding leading lady quality.
I've never done anything like this before. I'm really walking into these new grounds. I'm petrified.
Oh, I miss him so much when he's gone. But when he's near me, I don't let on.
Jodie's performance was much more emotional.
That was the toughest thing in there. It really gets you, that song.
I'll love him, right or wrong.
I didn't quite get the same sense of courage that I got from the other performances.
We all know the song, sang it enough times. It's really different. We're just going to kind of relearn the words.
As long as life is long, I'll love him, right or wrong.
At the beginning, I felt that she was parroting the words and I was disappointed. And then she knelt down, there were tears in her eye.
When someone needs you, you love them so.
And I felt here was an actress. Of all four girls, I think Rachel's was the most imaginative. You did feel you were hearing the message. It's going to be a very, very close contest. I can't predict how it's going to turn out.
From the 19th century to the 1960s, here performing A Hard Day's Night and all praying that their night isn't about to get any harder, it's our Fab Four Nancys!
Bye.
through to next week's live final, and only one can go on to star opposite our winning Olivers. It's certainly been an epic adventure. Let's take a look at the West End's newest leading men, Harry, Gwion and Lawrence.
I want you to be Oliver.
Harry is a great actor. Whether he's acting or whether he's singing, you feel a fantastic warmth and confidence.
I would love you to be Oliver.
Oh, I'd never thought I'd be Oliver, and I'm just so proud of it.
Gwion, there's something all around about him that is so lovable.
He's also very strong, and I think he's going to capture the audience heart.
Lawrence, well, wonderful voice. He also has a tremendous potential as an actor.
It's incredibly emotional when you watch him sing, and I really am proud of him that he has made this tremendous journey.
I want you to play Oliver.
Three very different Olivers, and I think whichever Oliver you go and see, you're going to get a fantastic performance.
Three bright young stars are set to shine in the West End. Performing Where Is Love for the very first time, please welcome Gwion, Harry and Lawrence, your Olivers! Here they are. And next Saturday, our winning Olivers will be performing duets with our Nancys in the live final. But which Nancys will they be? Rachel, Jessie, Samantha or Jodie?
I believe I should be in the final because I have never been more ready for a part. I believe it is my time. I won't let the public down.
Every week I put my heart and I put my soul into every performance, and I have got the heart to be Nancy, and I'll make that promise to every single person that I will go out there and I will always give 110%.
I think I deserve to be Nancy because I am ready to take on, you know, that task. I think I'd make a raw Nancy, a kind of raw, slightly edgy, different Nancy.
I could redefine Nancy. I'm fresh, I'm youthful. Oh, I'm built like an ox. I'm ready for 9 shows a week, never mind 8 shows.
None of them wants to leave, but someone has to. Before we announce the results, let's ask the panel, based on this week's performance, who is not Nancy? John.
Because her emotional content isn't in her song and I don't think she's emotionally ready, Jessie.
Denise.
I don't think she's ready, Jessie.
Barry.
This is agonising. They're all so wonderful. But it's Jodie is not Nancy for me.
Cameron.
And because I don't feel that Jodie has quite the grit of Nancy, it's Jodie for me as well.
Well, thanks to the viewers' votes, there are now only 2 guaranteed places in next week's live final. The 2 Nancys with the fewest votes must perform in our sing-off in front of Andrew. He can only save one of them. Another Nancy's dream is about to come to an end. Rachel, you've worked so hard to prove you could be Nancy and want to make your family in Belfast proud. Jesse, you've tried to remain true to yourself and desperately want to be accepted as Nancy. Samantha, your confidence has grown week by week, and you now truly believe you could be a leading lady. Jody, in the course of this competition, you have become a serious contender. But are you in the grand final? All the votes have been counted and verified. I will now announce the results in no particular order. Jody. You could still be Nancy. Congratulations. Rachel. You're in the sing-off. Come and join me, please. Samantha and Jesse, please step down. One of you has a guaranteed place in next week's final. One of you is on very dangerous ground and is in the sing-off. Jesse, you could still be Nancy. You're safe. Congratulations. Go and join the others. Which means, Samantha, you are in a sing-off with Rachel. Rachel, if you go, go and join Samantha there. So, Rachel and Samantha, you are the two least popular Nancys. One of you received the lowest number of votes. And if it were down to viewers' votes alone, I can reveal the person that would be out of the competition is Samantha. But Samantha, there's still hope, as Andrew may decide to save you. You must both now perform Memory from Cats, the song all four of you have been rehearsing this week and none of you wanted to sing. Remember, Andrew composed this song and will be listening to every note. Andrew, this is your final and most important save of the series. What must Rachel and Samantha do now?
I'm going to first say that this is exactly the result I did not want to happen. But what you have to do now is just, look, be a star. Show that sacred flame that a star must show in a moment like this.
Okay, Rachel, you will begin the sing-off, and then Samantha. Here singing to impress Andrew Lloyd Webber and win his final and casting vote, it's Rachel and Samantha.
When the dawn comes, tonight will be a memory too, and a new day will begin. Burnt out ends of smoky days, the stale cold smell of morning. The street lamp dies, another night is over, another
far. This is really heartbreaking, but one of you has done enough to convince Andrew. We're about to find out who. Andrew, for the final time, Rachel or Samantha, who will you save?
Well, first off, I'm sure Cameron's going to share this with me. This is the most devastating moment because here am I seeing Memory, which was sung by a young cat to the older cat, and it was everything about the first show that we did together. Now, here am I, faced with this... I mean, really, it's an impossible choice. Because on the one hand, Samantha, you're fabulous, you've got everything ahead of you. Rachel, you know, you did a wonderful performance at Cabaret, and I really don't know what to say. But I've got to make a decision, and I've got to think of where the show, ultimately, for Cameron, is going to go. And... I think I have to go with you, Samantha.
In the final, go join the others. Oh. Oh, Rachel. I'm so sorry, darling. Huge, huge disappointment. You came this close.
Very close.
This close. Oh, is there one of those girls you'd like to see go all the way now?
You know what? The three girls are absolutely amazing.
We love you.
Thank you. You have been amazing. I mean, I could see them all play it. I can't decide.
Andrew, I've got to ask you. Rachel, she said she was the safe pair of hands. She gave an amazing performance at Cabaret.
It was a fantastic performance tonight. And I just know you've got this huge career ahead of you. You were fantastic. Yay! And I don't know what to think.
Rachel, you've been an amazing part of the competition. Yes, of course you have.
Thank you so much. This has been amazing for me. Thank you.
All right. Well, you do have one more thing to do, and that's to say goodbye. Off you go, Rachel. Andrew Lloyd Webber has lost all his power. Now you're taking over. Next week, your votes alone decide who becomes Nancy. Join me for our live final next Saturday at the earlier time of 6 o'clock on BBC One, when our remaining three Nancys will be battling it out to win that dream West End role of a lifetime. Until then, I leave you with Rachel and our Nancys to say goodbye in their own special way. See you next Saturday.
As long.
Yes, he does. He needs me. In spite of what you see, I'm sure that he needs me. If you are lonely, then you will know.